What's going on, critters? Thanks for stopping by. Look what we got going on here. The girls are working the old pollen feeder. Look at them. They're just wallering around in there like a bunch of hogs in slop. Look at him. He's getting a little on his feet, and then he jumps up there, and he packs it between his into his baskets. Yeah. I'm liking this stuff. It's been out here for 2 days. And what I did here, I took a little yogurt cup. And that's kind of rain, got a little rain in it. What I did is put a 1-to-1 sugar water in there, put some pine straw so they don't drown, and hung it here. Of course, they jumped on the syrup right away. I fed them here for 2 days until my substitute came in. That's Ultra B in there, by the way. Seemed to like it. And they're just basically finding it now. Little trap, it's a little feeder. It's only 10 inches long. I think that's plenty. Took one of them good sized drink cups, plastic drink cups. I used it as a scoop. I bought a 50 pound bag and a 10 pound bucket, and I'm gonna use my bucket as a, you know, when I go to the field or whatever. I got another location where I can go. And but you're supposed to keep that stuff at room temperature. So I got my 60 pound sack I got in the house in a closet. And then the bucket I keep in the utility room. So when I go to the field, I can just grab it out the door and go. But yeah, I'm liking this. The girls seem to be liking this pollen. They're packing in a lot of it. We're gonna pump these bees up. As you saw the other day, we were making these up. I've got 418. I'll go into this hive. I mean 518. I'm sorry, 518. That'll be a month. I got another one down here, 518. This one here, gonna be 518. There's a 5-6. I'm going into that one. 5-6, it'll be a month. That was the original location on that one hive there. This one here was too. I'm putting in some sheets in here too. Some Swiffer sheets. I'm gonna see what that does. See if them beetles will get tangled up in that stuff. And yeah, these bees are still a little bit testy here. I've got some queens coming in. I'm going to change out some of this genetics here. I don't like what I got going on here. But here's a 4-6, 4-6. This one's queen right. I'm going to go into her probably on 5-6. I'll go into her and see what she's doing. I'm feeding everybody here. They're sucking up the syrup pretty good. Sucking up the syrup. I'm going to keep them loaded. This one doesn't have bees in it yet. It's just an empty box. But yeah, I thought I'd show you the around here real quick. I've been out here cutting up some wood, making a few more bottoms for my beefy beehives. I'm really liking these beehives, guys. You might want to think about getting it. Here's another thing you can do with this wood. I don't know if you have a vinyl fence place anywhere near you, but this is what I'm getting. This is what I'm making all of my bee equipment out of it. These things. You're throwing away these things by the truckloads. What it is, they run piping. They're not piping, it's a box, a plastic box that they run that vinyl fencing in. That's getting quite popular. And they encompass it with this frame and a couple 3 points. And they used to nail it and then gusset, and they don't do that anymore. What they're doing is putting on these straps that go here, see, through. Now, I need to get up there because this is all I have left. And I want to knock out a bunch more. But all this right on down to the frames and make everything with it, frames. Here's something else you can do with this. You make compost bins out of these. Compost bins, okay? There's a skink, Florida skink. Anyway, yeah. And you could, what I'm going to do, I'm fixing to rotate this pile. So what I'll do is take this, throw it over here, get a pitchfork, and rotate this whole thing over. That's that. I'm fixing to bust up and call it a day. This is all I got left in Nukes. Those are all I got left in Nukes. So, and I got a few bottoms, a few tops going extra. So yeah, I got to get busy and bang out some more. Let's bang out about 500 of these. What do you think? Now, got a mess here. If you go sawing this stuff up in your garage or whatever, yeah, you're going to have a flipping mess. And then, you know, your bride is able to get on you. So, what do? We got the mess out here, right? You've got sawdust on the grass, right? That's good. Fertilizer. All right, now we're going to clean up the shop. I thought I'd show you how we clean up the shop here. Here we go. You ready? Is that fast enough for you? There, my shop's all clean. Yeah, put my saws up. Gotta throw that wood. Well, actually, a lot of this wood will be cut into frames. But I wanted to show you one more little project. I had an extra top, and I was sitting there looking at it, drinking my tea, taking a little break. And I said, what can I do with this extra top? And that's the top right there. That's the top. What I did, I've usually just got a little tackle box. I threw all my stuff in, and then you got to dig around in it. Yeah, you're wasting more time digging around in a box. So what I did is threw this together. Used Bondtite 3, by the way. 3/4 plywood. Give you some quick measurement. This box is 23 long, 12 wide, and these end pieces are 10.5 inches. I had an old broom handle laying around here, threw that in there, drilled a 1-inch hole, put that in. Add some leather. Go to the craft store like Hobby Lobby and get this. You can get this really cheap leather cutoffs. And I made a couple little holsters for my hive tools. Something else I do with my hive tools. I've got that number 30 tar nylon, and I do a wrap on them. You see that? It makes a very comfortable, non-slippy grip on that thing. And that tar nylon, when you do this wrap, tuck under deal, it stays. It doesn't back off like untreated. This is tarred nylon. It's number 30. I get it at Memphis Net and Twine, where I get my catfish supplies. So yeah, I made a little couple of holsters, just tacked it in. And this was pure accident right here. This thing fit right in this. I left a stub sticking out, and I just stuck it up there, and I looked and I said, are you kidding me? Look at that. There's my smoker. So on this end, I got to made a couple pouches for my grill lighters, right? You need a couple of those in case one craps out. And here's my bead brush. I have a plumber strap. So I just threw that on there, and it sits there. You didn't want to put it this way because you want to want your brush all, you know, ruffled up. You want to ruffle its feathers, you know? There you go. Stick that in there. That's that. I made a couple little pouches from essential oils. Got a little lemongrass. I got a little lemongrass here and a little thyme oil, white thyme. I've got some markers. And then this is what I use on my hives. Just take a piece of this duct tape here. So that's the real thin stuff. It's not the real beefy stuff. It's kind of the thin stuff. And that's what I throw on there to mark up my dates on the hives. So yeah, I got a couple of frame fixtures. I've got some extra pins, nail for frame pins. I got a little hammer in here. I got a couple of stainless queen cages, some marking pins. I got some, this is something you guys need to pick up if you fool around with Tanglefoot, because that stuff is nasty, but this will cut it. You just keep a couple rolls of paper towels in your truck when you go from BR to BR. These are good here. These are what the girls use on their ponytails and whatnot, and long-haired hippies too. This works great for putting around your sleeves. If when the elastic wears out on your bee suits, you can throw that on. Keep a bunch of them in there. Say you've got pant legs or bees are tearing your legs up, whatever. Take some, use electrical tape. Usually I buy this in big rolls, and it comes on and off you really fast. You put duct tape on your, here's some Gorilla tape I use for emergency use for certain things. But if you put this on your pants, you're gonna have a heck of a time getting it off. But plain old electrical tape is great. And by the way, I was throwing these together. These are my, but we went through this the other day. I showed you how to do the porch. I'm loving these, guys. I'm loving these. Something else I'm loving, look at here. This was on sale, Harbor Freight. Yeah, you'd think as many times as I'm down there, I must be part owner. Oh, Central Pneumatic. This thing was $15. Yeah, I'm shooting 18 gauge. This thing will do either or. It'll do crown staples or 18 gauge, you could go up to staples up to 1.5 inches, 18 gauge brad nails to 2 inch. Well, I'm putting this together because I want to use just one size, 1.25 inches, put my frames together. I'm gluing them also. I glued this to here. So anyway, that's what I use. $15, I mean, it speeds it up. You can knock these things out fast. So this is a cool tool. Get you one of them. I have a pretty good size air compressor. I've got extra generator, whatever. I need to go to the field with generators, whatever. But yeah, I thought I'd show you my quickie little box here. You can throw your stuff in, your rubber gloves. It just makes everything. I've got beetle blasters. And I'm gonna throw in this box. And also, I'm going to put in some vegetable oil in here alongside of this. I think I'm going to make a little bungee strap here with a couple eye hooks so I can go around the veggie oil. Because if this cap ever come loose and fell over in here, you're going to have a juicy mess in this. So I'm going to put a little eyelet here, one here, and trap my vegetable oil and baby oil up in there. So that's something you guys can throw together very quickly. I mean, this took me maybe, I don't think I got an hour in fooling around with the whole thing. Plus what I did was put this in my eco-friendly wood preservative. That's where these bottoms are fixing to go here in a minute. I've got one more in there I got to put a porch on, and that'll wrap that up, and I'm done for the day. Quick tour. Catch you guys later. Be happy. Make them bees. Lots of bees. See you later, guys. Bye-bye.